The only thing I knew about wasps before this video was that they're those flying insects that hover around picnics and sting people. That was it. I assumed, naively, that wasps had no useful role in the world's ecosystem. So when someone from the Oregon Department of Agriculture got in touch and said that they send out taxpayer-funded wasps, I had some questions, like, why?
This is pest control at an ecosystem-wide level. There are hundreds of thousands of species of wasp, and only a handful of those actually sting people. The vast, vast majority of them go about their entire life and you never see them or notice them.
Around the turn of the century, the brown marmorated stink bug arrived in the United States. It's originally from East Asia, but enough of them had been carried in accidentally by global trade that a breeding population started and then exploded. Those stink bugs are now found across most of the continent, and they consume crops like apples, pears, hazelnuts, and soybeans, causing millions of dollars in damage every year.
They are a generalist pest. They feed on hundreds of different plant species, and they have a great range of climatic conditions that they're perfectly happy to live in. Its populations have reproduced without anything to check it.
So what you want is the stink bug's natural enemy, which is a particular type of wasp that's being bred inside this chamber.
Parasitoid wasps attack other insects and lay their eggs inside of them to reproduce. Sometimes that's an insect egg, sometimes they eat the insect alive, starting at the least vital organs first. This is where the inspiration for the chestburster from Alien came from. We breed the stink bugs because the parasitoid wasps need them to reproduce in. As many stink bug eggs as we have is about as many wasps as we can produce. Last year, we produced around 20,000, and the year before that, we produced around 17,000.
And they are tiny. I didn't realize until I got here and saw them that you could have wasps that are only about a millimeter long. They're so delicate that the researchers can't use tweezers to move them around. They have to gently suck them up through chiffon fabric using the housing of a ballpoint pen. But human intervention in ecosystems doesn't have a great history. So my next question was, well, how do they know what to release and where?
Researchers from USDA and different universities went to Asia to find out what attacks it in Asia and why is it not such a big problem there. They brought Trisulcus japonicus back over to the United States into quarantine facilities, tested it on North American species to see if there were any that we didn't test in Asia that it could also attack. Decades of work go into making sure that the wasps that we're releasing are also safe. If we give it brown marmorated stink bug eggs and any other stink bug, it'll choose brown marmorated stink bug 95%+ of the time. But if you give it just another stink bug egg mass, it will use it if there's no other choice. So we were actually a little on the fence about whether or not we wanted to release it. And then it showed up anyways.
After years and years of work, the wasps showed up anyway. Because every year, millions of flights land and millions of shipping containers arrive at ports, and it's not like those are sterile. So now that the fight is being set up out in the wild anyway, why do they still breed and release these?
The parasitoid wasp needs some time to catch up. It's around a millimeter and a half long. It can't fly very far. We can drive it a lot further than it can fly in a single year. So we actually get those populations started without having to fly across the entire state of Oregon. Normally the growers reach out to the Department of Agriculture and we go out to a site visit. Not every site is suitable for these wasps. They're actually nectar feeders and pollinators, so they actually do need other plants present. They can provide permanent, long-lasting pest control for not just growers, but the entire ecosystem. These do not sting people. I have worked with not only this wasp, but other wasps that are much larger than it, that are parasitoid wasps, and I have never been stung, and I've been working on these for over a decade.